Yesterday we talked about a new movie for the Power Rangers, and in that video, we mentioned the Power Rangers Turbo movie. Because of this, I wanted to watch the movie again to find out if it really was as bad as we have thought it was for so many years. In this video, we are going to talk about everything that this movie means, the good things, and the bad things. This movie is the introduction of Turbo Power, as it premiered in March 1997 and the Turbo season in the series premiered in April 1997. It is also the first appearance of Divatox, a villain who is an evil space pirate who on this occasion seeks to unleash a powerful monster to marry him and join forces. This monster is called Malagor, which is made of volcanic lava and was buried on an island thousands of years ago by the ancestors of the wizard Laragoth. This same wizard had the key that opens the portal to free Malagor, and that is why Divatox was looking for him. Only the wizard could use this key, which was like a magic wand, and that is why Divatox trapped the wizard's family to force him to open the portal. Laragoth fled to Earth to try to save himself, but the Earth's sun was weakening him, and he was in danger of dying. Zordon knew this wizard, so Alpha was able to detect him, and the Rangers were sent to find him to save his life in the command center. I don't want to summarize the movie for you since many have already seen it, so let's go to the important details to find out if this movie actually was as bad as many fans say it was. Let's start with the good things, and that is that, despite everything, the story of this movie is good. I'm not talking about the dialogues, I'm not talking about the drama, I'm talking about the central idea of the movie and the style it had. If we summarize the movie very quickly, we can realize that in reality, the central idea has a lot of potential, and that it was simply the execution of how they did the rest that didn't work. The summarized story is that a space pirate wants to join forces with a very old evil being which is very powerful, but to achieve that she must open a portal with the magic wand of a magician, and the Power Rangers must stop this pirate. This story is very interesting because it makes us want to know who will be that powerful evil being that we are promised from the beginning of the film. Best of all, the pirate managed to free the monster and we got to see it in action. Another thing I should mention about the story is the style they gave to the whole movie, and it was a combination of suspense, comedy, and action. Honestly, it would have been better if the comedy didn't exist in this movie, but since it is aimed at a very young audience, the producers must include it to be accepted by that audience. There are many parts that have a little bit of terror, such as the part of the boat, which is full of spider webs and uses a strange power to move by itself. Besides this, the physicality of the monster is quite scary, and possibly with better special effects it would have been very scary. A curious detail about this character is that the production used the same costume to play Dark Spectre, and Divatox herself refers to this when she tells Dark Spectre that he reminds her a lot of her fiancé. This is obviously a very sarcastic line on the part of the production, since they used the same costume, even though it's not really the same character. The difference is that Dark Spectre can talk and is also much more powerful. Another detail I like about Turbo is that I have always liked the helmets, as they have a great design and make them look much better in Morphin. Basically, these are the positive details of the movie, although it seems little. I really think that the story is the most important thing, and here it was very good. The negative details that this movie had are very similar to the negative details that the series has, and it seems that they didn't learn anything from the mistakes of the movie. The first huge mistake that Power Rangers Turbo has is to have a child as part of the Power Rangers team, and I can't show his pictures since I can have problems with YouTube because of the new regulations. This idea of having a kid in the team was done to try to attract more young audiences, since they could identify with this character. I must admit that when I saw this movie, I was 7 years old, and I was very excited when I saw that this character had become a Power Rangers. This means that the idea that the production had really worked, but now that I am an adult, I think this ruined the plot as the Rangers had to be always looking out for him. In addition to this, it was also ridiculous that that character was starting to grow at the time of Morphin. We know this is all fantasy, but there is a fine line between fantasy and ridiculous. Another very important thing that was very negative for the movie is that the Rangers made the transformation very few times, and this is part of the essence of the Power Rangers. If we make a brief comparison with the first Mighty Morphin movie, we will know that they did the transformation several times. Also, this same thing happened in a special episode in which we could see that the Rangers made the transformation many times. Another negative thing is that they didn't give details about the origin of the new turbo power, and the beginning of this power was very simple. Zordon already had the keys ready, and the Rangers only had to hold them for the power to enter them. Something very negative that Turbo has always had are the Zords, and I want to explain the reason for this since many may not understand how terrible they are. The Zords are modified cars that basically act as if they have a life of their own, plus each Zord has a name and each one has the color of the Ranger it belongs to. That's all well and good. What's wrong is that they are cars, and although they are not ordinary cars, they are still cars. A Zord should be something special, something that is not so common, powerful machines that you can only use in special situations, and in the movie the opposite happened. The Rangers used these cars for everything, they even used them simply as a means of transportation, and I understand that they can have that utility, but that's exactly what takes away the specialness. Something that was very negative in the movie is that it seems that the producers forgot that the most important thing in Power Rangers are the fights, and, in this movie, there were very few fights. One of the most interesting things about Power Rangers is being able to see your heroes destroying enemies with fists, kicks, spins, jumps, and many cool weapons. In this movie, we had to wait until the end to see a long fight sequence, as we had previously only seen a short battle on the ship. You can think of any other Power Rangers movie, and you can realize that they all have a lot of fights. To end this video, I must say that the character of Divatox was a bad choice for this movie, and this is not to say that she is a bad character. What I mean is that she is a character with a lot of charisma, a lot of silly comedy, she is quite a sexualized character, and besides this, there is nothing scary about her. Villains should be characters that cause fear, that make you feel that the Rangers are in danger and that are very powerful beings. Divatox just seems like a spoiled woman who has no powers, and that can be good for the series since their everything has a simpler style. In this movie with a dark style, they should have had a villain that causes a lot of fear and looks very powerful. There are many more details that we can mention, so give me your opinion in the comments, and soon we will make a video comparing this movie with others to know at what level we can rate it.